loan amount, you want to find the monthly payments and her total interest. And hang on, I'm going to let you guys all do this, but I do know, pretty sure, that the payment amount that you're aiming for is $936.30.
I think.
Our realtor also can tell you what it's going to be with the approximate insurance and property taxes added in, because what will happen is the mortgage company will pay those directly to ensure that if your house burns down, they get all their money, and to make sure that you don't forget to pay your property taxes. Now, one other thing we need to point out before we leave here. You can calculate B. I put the answer there. You take your payment times the total number of payments and subtract off the loan amount. So here's the other thing you should notice. This is why we're in a whole slew of trouble now. A reputable lender will only approve a home loan if the total of the borrower's monthly payments, including the home loan payment, is 38%. Of their monthly income. This is not what didn't happen and why so many people are having trouble paying their bills. Now, in order to answer this question, we have to make a lot of assumptions. We have to assume that Shirley has no other monthly commitments. So she doesn't have cable, she doesn't have cars, she doesn't have insurance.
Can you have cable?
She doesn't have a phone. She doesn't have anything that could be considered a monthly commitment. Yeah, her life does. So she can have no other monthly commitment. And what this is saying is that her monthly income times 38%, which is 0.38, has to be at least $936.30. 38% of her monthly income has to equal this number.
So, how do you
tell me, how do I solve this equation?
Divide
by 0.38, so I'll have monthly income is going to equal $936.30. Divided by 0.38, which comes out to be, this is actually part of,
this is part of problem three, this is C.
And so 936.30, hang on. So this is going to be, that's a two. $2,463.95. Now, keep in mind that this is not very accurate because we assume she has no other monthly commitments. If you go buy a house, they're going to make you fill out a form talking about, do you have child support? How much do you have to pay out each month on your credit card? How much is your cable bill? How much is your phone bill? How much is this? So that they have all this information. And they make presumptions about things like how much it would cost you just to live, you know, food and all that stuff. So that's why they do this, and why we're in trouble, because lots of people didn't make sure that you could really afford the mortgage that you were